So, back at the sawmill today, we have a horse chestnut. Ooh, 72 inches exactly, so right at the 6 foot mark. Bark to bark, you're right at 45 on that end. And then bark to bark, you're right at 42. So pretty good sized log, no real taper. We do have an old limb that was rotten out, so we definitely had water feed in there a long time. Did rot out the bottom of the log, so you can see it comes through a little bit at the end, but on the other side it is about this size. So some of this will go dimensional. Ultimately we're going to get a couple live edge slabs, so we'll grab the skid steer and get this thing up to the mill. Okay, so we got it loaded on the mill. I kind of wanted these crotches of the tree. I understand that one's rotten, but I kind of wanted the crotches in line with each other so we can get as much figure as we can. Yeah, there was the larger of the two holes. But yeah, it's a pretty big log. You can see from this side we're going to catch a little bit, so we will trim this guy off real quick. And yeah, as far as the pith being level, it's a pretty good setup where it's at without being shimmed. We do have some shims for rocking, but it's not actually lifting anything. Yeah, so I'm gonna get that trimmed and then we'll get her cleaned up, check for metal real quick, and get to milling. Okay, took the first couple slabs off the horse chestnut. Nothing too crazy. I mean, obviously we knew that was going to be rotten from the side. These are always kind of neat. We didn't know if it was going to be rotten or not. So you can see where the arborist cut the limb years ago. The tree healed over the limb, and then the limb rotted out. So I think what we're going to do at this point is, if you follow me around here, we're going to get about a 10-inch bite going across off this top, and then we'll flip that upright and mill from there, and we will see what it looks like underneath there. Okay, we ended up taking about a 10-inch piece off, so this was the side it came off of. We're going to go and mill a flat piece up top to get a reference, and then we'll run her down lumber-wise. So yeah, it's pretty good size log still, just a little bit bigger of a void inside than we figured. Another slab we got off it, and there's the 10-inch chunk. We'll throw this back on the mill in a minute. So I said 10, just 9.5 shy. So anyway, we'll go ahead and keep breaking this one down. Okay, so we have the last cant reloaded on the mill. The rot's pretty bad down there, so the other two we milled out over there, the original one and the second one, those are both 9.5, and that seemed to work out really well with the rot, so I think with how I have the top cap coming off, we can go 9.5 down, and then probably just end up flipping this, and we'll hopefully be able to mill all four cants at once. Okay, just trying to maximize yield on this log. We have basically cut it into 6 cants. We have a couple of waste slabs for this one. But yeah, all this is gonna be 8-quarter stock as well. We'll have some book matches, but yeah, we'll get to milling this.
Yeah.
So here's another book match we pulled off the mill. Again, this is all 8-quarter. We're not too far into the log, and I love these book matches. Here's another little book match that's kind of neat. Has some nice curl in it. I'm sure that's just compression curl from a branch, but not complete slabs. Got a bunch of wane on that side, but pretty good looking book match still. I was just about to pressure wash this off. This was kind of a pretty book match. Well, still will be. But then I saw creepy crawlies. We got some termites. And down here, we had some good sized ones in there. So we'll clean this out, see how many termites we can spray on ourselves, and keep milling. Okay, so here is that book match set. Once the little bugs have been eradicated. I'm sure there's a few more termites in there, but they generally die pretty quick. Good looking book match. But yeah, we treat all of our slabs, both when we stack them and then when we kiln dry them, we treat them all with DE. So it seems we've never had any bug issues. So anyway, keep milling. Okay, so here's one of the cans opened up. We have this book match, that book match, and then this one and this one are book match if this one's flipped. But yeah, all of them have termite damage. And you know, it takes a lot of time to pressure wash all these, but What's worse is running that through your joiner and planer and having rocks and debris and picking it out with a dental pick. So we really try to clean things out, whether we're selling it or we're using it for our furniture company. We really try to pressure wash everything out before the drying process. Okay, so you can see we had a pretty good nest of termites in this one. So a lot of these are, you know, they do have a lot of termite damage, but a lot of these will become live edge or just get edged off in general for further use. Okay, so here they are, pressure washed off, post termites. Got a couple of pretty book matches, and then, got some survivors crawling around down there. Okay, we're gonna load up the other cans. Okay, got one of those cans pressure washed off. Again, a bunch of nice book matches. We had some more termite damage on these, but it looks like it's all old. I didn't see any critters flying at me when we were pressure washing. So yeah, that's this cant. We have the other one down there, so we're gonna wash it up and resume. Okay, I know you guys see a smiley face there as well. Yeah, so there was the other cant that we milled up. Again, a couple of really neat book matches. Yep, we have two more cans over there. Mill those up, show you what's inside. Okay, this is what came out of the last two cants. Yeah, again, we kind of book matched everything. There is some curl, some figure in here. It's pretty faint, pretty minor, but yeah, a lot of pretty pieces. So again, all of this is 8/4. We'll get it stickered and stacked and go from there. So this is what we ended up with the horse chestnut. So again, all of this is milled into 8/4 thickness. Since we milled so many cants, we kind of ended up with the vast majority of it being dimensional lumber. So they're all about 10 to 12 inches. So we'll take it down, stack it up, and see what it looks like.
Keep going. Keep going. A little bit. Stop.
Okay, well, we're wrapped up with that horse chestnut, so this was the big leaf maple, that's the horse chestnut. So again, pretty much everything was ended up being 8/4 and all dimensional. So yeah, wraps up for the day. So again, you know, if you feel like you're getting anything out of this, you know, go ahead and like the video, comment. Like I said, if you want to see a certain log, we have some crazy walnut logs, Claro, Black, English, Bass Stone, we have them all. So let me know if you want to see a certain size of a certain species. And again, if you think I earned it, subscribe. I'd appreciate it. All right, guys, we'll see you on the next one.